You probably already have a vague notion of Stegosaurus and other dinosaurs running amok and being trampled by roaring, panicked T-Rexes while fiery asteroids rain down from the heavens and burn them all to death. Well, yeah, some dinosaurs were killed by asteroids, but the mass extinction of the dinosaurs is a little more complicated than that. First, it's thought that dinosaurs roamed the Earth for about 200 million years. It's likely that many types of dinosaurs lived and died out long before extinction ended them all for good. There are three consecutive geologic time periods within the Mesozoic era during which the dinosaurs lived: the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous periods. Different dinosaur species lived during each of these three periods. The Jurassic period dinosaur, the Stegosaurus, had already been extinct for approximately 80 million years before the Cretaceous period dinosaur, the Tyrannosaurus, came to be. So no, Tyrannosaurus never trampled the Stegosaurus while running from asteroids. At the end of the Cretaceous period, there was a mass extinction where around 75% of life on Earth was suddenly wiped out. This included everything from fish to trees to T-Rex. This even is called the Cretaceous Tertiary, or KT, extinction, which occurred 66 million years ago. The extinction is apparent in the geological record. No dinosaur remains have been found in the rocks younger than 66 million years. So try to wrap your mind around this crazy fact. The time period separating the existence of Stegosaurus and Tyrannosaurus, 80 million years, is greater than the time period separating Tyrannosaurus and modern humanity, or you, 66 million years. For many, many years, paleontologists thought the mass die-off was most likely caused by climate change, which disrupted the dinosaurs' food supply. In 1980, nuclear physicist Luis Alvarez and his son, geologist Walter Alvarez, were conducting research in Italy. They discovered a layer of iridium-rich clay in the K-PG boundary, which marks the end of the Cretaceous period. This layer has around 200 more times the amount of iridium in it compared to the strata formed before and after. This is significant because iridium is rare on Earth, but much more common in space. The Alvarezes hypothesized that the iridium was deposited because of an astronomical event where a large meteor, comet, or asteroid collided with the Earth. Furthermore, this enormous impact could have caused the extinction of the dinosaurs. In 1991, a massive meteor crater was discovered on the edge of the Yucatan Peninsula, extending into the Gulf of Mexico. The Chicxulub crater, which was named for a nearby village, is 112 miles in diameter. For many in the scientific community, this crater confirms the Alvarez hypothesis. It has become the widely accepted theory for the extinction of non-avian dinosaurs. Researchers believe that around 66 million years ago, an enormous asteroid somewhere between the 6 to 9 miles in diameter range struck the Earth at 40,000 miles per hour. The impact released 2 million times more energy than the biggest nuclear bomb. But even with such a massive impact, how could that kill the majority of life on Earth, including dinosaurs thousands of miles from the impact zone? As the massive asteroid streaked across the sky, chunks may have broken off, igniting wildfires wherever they landed. When the asteroid slammed into the Yucatan Peninsula, it bore several miles down into the seafloor, creating a bubbling cauldron of melting rock and super-hot gases. This created an effect similar to a volcanic plume. Heated seawater and lava were ejected mountain-high into the atmosphere. The plume quickly collapsed back into the sea, where it cooled, altering temperature, currents, and the land formation. The asteroid also vaporized sulfur-rich rocks, releasing an estimated 357 billion tons of sulfur gas into the air. Some of the gas quickly fell as acid rain, acidifying the ocean and killing off most marine life. At the same time, virtually all life within around 1,000 miles of the impact was incinerated due to the heat. The impact also created a shockwave and displaced ocean water, forming a towering tsunami that might have traveled as far inland as present-day Illinois before receding. The particles of dust and gases tossed into the atmosphere blocked the sun, plunging the Earth into darkness and cold temperatures. The lack of sunlight reaching plants caused a massive collapse of the ecosystem throughout the whole food chain. The majority of plants and trees rapidly died off. Shortly thereafter, herbivores starved to death because they had nothing to eat. The carnivorous dinosaurs lasted a little longer since they could feast on the dead and dying herbivores, but within a month or so of the asteroid impact, most of life on Earth had died. Only small, scavenging animals were quickly able to adapt and survive. These animals, which most likely subsisted on insects and seeds, burrowed into the ground to escape the cold. Over time, these creatures evolved into modern reptiles and birds. So technically, dinosaurs never went fully extinct, they just became canaries and chickens. Could an astronomical event destroy life as we know it on Earth? Check out our answer here. If a crocodile fought a great white shark, who would win? Or are they evenly matched? See the victor here.